Kathy, Roberta, I want to talk to you about the Quills Language Screener and other things. We'll get to those. Mm-hmm. But first, tell me about the Quills Language Screener. What is it? Why is it needed?
Well, there are very few measures of early language development. And most of those early measures of language development take a professional to come in, to take a fair amount of time, and then to assess the young child. Now, language is the single best predictor of how young kids are going to do both at entry to school and in their trajectories through school.
And what do you mean by that? Language is the capability, the depth of language.
So if we assessed your language in kindergarten, it would help us account for how you did in math, social studies, reading, and science.
And what do you look at in language? Maybe this gets to the screener itself.
What the screener is.
Measures. Yeah.
So we desperately need this screener, because if children know the names of their letters, that's nice, but that's not enough for learning to read. So what the Quills enables us to do is to assess children's language in the most fun and entertaining way. Kids love this and ask to do it again. It takes 15 minutes, it's on a tablet, it's entirely based in the research literature.
And it doesn't require
a skilled examiner.
A skilled examiner.
That's huge. It should be done in schools, by teachers, by aides. They don't even have to do anything. They just have to sit with the kid. The questions come out of the tablet, and the tablet scores the child's scores. And then the child can be compared to others in his grade or to a national sample, the norms that we have assembled.
So the question then becomes, what does it do?
Yes.
How many words do you know? Do you know Do you know the kinds of words that kids your age generally know? How about your ability to put those words together in sentences? And we call that, you know, grammar or syntax. Are you where you need to be in syntax? How about in your learning to learn skills? Can you take a nonsense word and know to extend it to another thing that looks just like it, but it's a different color? All those skills are really critically important.
Everything is dependent on language.
And what feedback are you getting on the screener itself?
Getting great feedback.
Yeah,
somebody gave
fabulous.
A talk at the Boston Child Language Meeting, and they actually wrote in their slides, "We were not paid to put this in."
and it's also that, you know, we have this Quills now is coming out in a bilingual version that will be Spanish and English.
We should give the ages.
That's right. The ages are 3 through 6. Mm. And we're currently working on a 2-year-old version. And there's even less out there for measuring early language with 2-year-olds.
And I can only imagine that on the negative side, identifying potential concerns or issues, even more important at 2
Absolutely.
Than at 3,
That's
than
right.
at 6, that you catch it early.
We know That's for right. 1,000 years that the earlier you get in with any kind of developmental problem and try to ameliorate it, the better.
Finally, I can't have a conversation with New York Times best-selling authors without asking them about the book. So, Becoming Brilliant, What Science Tells Us About Raising Successful Children. In a minute or later, what does science tell us about?
So the kinds of skills that Kathy and I have incorporated in this book based on psychological research are just the skills that children need to succeed, not just in school, but in the world, in the job market, and for health. Content, the 3 R's, are crucially important, but there's so much more. Would you have your job if you couldn't collaborate and communicate with the people who are helping you here? I don't think so. So those are 2 of the skills.
Those are 2.
Plus
so there are
content.
3 R's, but there are 6 C's,
That's
if I'm not
right.
mistaken.
Yeah.
What
right.
are the 6 C's? So you just did 2.
We did communication, content, and collaboration.
Yes, you did 3.
Critical thinking, which is dependent on content, which is dependent on communication, which is dependent on collaboration. They're all interrelated. Creative innovation, very important in a 21st century. And then finally, we added confidence, that ability to take an intellectual risk, that ability to learn from failure, and to keep on going, persistence and grit. These 6 C's as an integrative model were derived from thousands and thousands of papers in the science of learning, and now are being translated into schools around the country, and we are actually doing model schools that have become 6C schools.
It's easy to understand why it's a New York Times best-selling book.
Thanks.
So congratulations to both
you.
Of you, and thank you. Thank you for continuing the conversation with
sure.
me.
Thank
oh,
you.
Thank you for continuing it with us.